Welcome to this KSTP.com sports wrap. I'm Joe Schmit along with Chris Long. We're going to talk a little Wild hockey right now. You know, the Wild, interesting, they played like four games in the first 2 weeks. Now all of a sudden they have six games in the next 9 days.
I feel like there was less time between the series they played against the Blackhawks in opening night than there's been the two games against the Avalanche. But it's so weird to see no momentum can carry over. You do. You get the excitement of opening night. Darcy Kuemper came out of the gate in a hurry, but all the momentum kind of dried up. They have trouble on the West Coast, and now we'll see what happens in this stretch.
Yeah, you know, and it's interesting because I think more of the action is taking place off the ice. I like what Chuck Fletcher's done. The fact that he's decided that we've got Ryan Suter, we've got Zach Parise locked down, let's put some talent around him. They'd signed Coyle. They had already signed Niederreiter. They already signed Brodin. That's a smart move.
I love all the moves they've done. The way you get in trouble is if it's a miss. If Charlie Coyle regresses, if Nino Niederreiter regresses. Not saying I think that's going to happen. I don't think that's going to happen. But obviously when you start signing guys to long-term contracts, they've got to perform and they've got to keep up the pace that they've been doing. Yeah, I agree with you 100%, but if somebody falls off a little this season, next season, they might wish they had.
And we could compare that to the Twins when the Twins signed Nick Blackburn to a long-term contract, and all of a sudden, what looked like a good deal early all of a sudden wasn't such a good deal. Goaltending is going to be the question most of the year, and you mentioned, you know, Darcy started off hot. Backstrom, I think, actually looked pretty good in his game. So, I mean, that's still going to be the issue.
Yeah, and the question was, for me anyway, I don't think they went into the season thinking Nick Backstrom was going to be the number one guy. Josh Harding's health was a question, and is Darcy Kuemper ready? Well, all he did was came charging out of the gates and set a franchise record for shutout streak. So I think right now you go into this stretch saying it's going to be about a 60-40 split with Kuemper getting the 60%, Backstrom getting the 40, and right now I think that's a recipe for success.
You know what? I'd be surprised. I would think that Kemper's even going to get more games than 60%. I'm going to disagree with you a little bit. The wild card of this deal is what happens when Harding comes back and Harding's healthy, because there's no way the Wild would carry three goalies.
You don't want to trade Darcy Kuemper, and I don't know if you can trade Nick Backstrom with his contract or Josh Harding with his injury and MS concern. So you're going to be stuck in a situation where Darcy Kuemper, I think, is the only guy they can send down to Iowa, but he's being paid like a number one guy, and he looks like a number one guy.
And if he's playing 60, as you say, or 70%, as I say, you're not going to send that guy down.
No, so, they're stuck.
But listen, it may be an interesting problem to have if the goalies are playing well, so that one may play itself out. Other than that, I think, you know, they've got to score. The power play has been terrible. They haven't scored in a power play yet. But it's so early in the season. How can you really judge what they've done?
What you're going to see with the power play, two slumps are going to break at the same time. Thomas Vanek and the power play slump.
Yeah.
They're going to be one and the same. That power play is going to start to click. Thomas Vanek, I bet in the next, let's say, three games, he scores two power play goals. That gets him going. That gets a power play going, because he's been, and it's early, I don't want to say disappointing, I don't want to say a bust. He hasn't been Thomas Vanek. He's not going to be like this all year. He will catch fire here soon.
And Marin Gabrick's been very good for the Wild this year. Oh, that was old, man. That was old school.
That was pre-internet.
Oh, it was pre-internet. Okay. Since that was pre-internet, that's where we're going to wrap it up. This has been Sports Rep at KSTP.com. He's Chris Long. I'm Joe Schmit, and you're happy.